What's going on, guys? BlinkFro here, and today I'm bringing you another Seattle Seahawks franchise video. This is the Super Bowl against the Pittsburgh Steelers. We have no one injured on our team, and the Steelers have a couple key players. I believe they're all starters. Mendenhall, Pouncey, and Kamita. I don't even know how to say his name. I'm not even going to attempt it because I didn't even look to see how it was spelled, so it's not even like I can sound it out. So here we go. The Seattle Seahawks versus the Pittsburgh Steelers said already. Ben Roethlisberger, don't know why he's wearing a teal tie, but maybe he just felt like he needed to support the Seattle Seahawks because he thought it was funny that they lost the last Super Bowl that they played against the Steelers. So, yeah. And I'm pretty pumped to play Madden 13. I know it's still a ways away, but those new Seattle Seahawks uniforms, it's going to be really cool to see how they look like in the game. And I'm actually considering buying a Seattle Seahawks jersey. I know I'm a Packers fan, but I don't know. I'm very tempted to buy a Matt Flynn Seahawks jersey. Call me crazy, but I think it would be pretty cool. I just want to see how the Seahawks jerseys look like, you know, after them playing like a game or two. Just to make sure I like them a lot. And I wasn't sure if I should show you the introductions, but I decided to do it anyways because it is the Super Bowl. And if you guys can tell, this video is like 18 minutes long. So yeah, I pretty much showed you every single play of the game except for a couple incomplete passes. So this should be an interesting commentary. See if I can keep things going for 18 minutes without like blabbering on too much or just sounding like a complete idiot if I haven't done so already. So we win the coin toss, and as always, we elect to kick because I just like getting the ball in the second half. And I'm not exactly, oh yeah, I think I just showed the opening kickoff because you can see all the little camera bulbs going off. So Ben Roethlisberger, he liked to scramble a lot. I don't know why. The very first play of the game, Ben Roethlisberger's like, I got this team. And he scrambles for 4 yards. Second play, he completes the pass, and third down, they're going to get stopped. KJ Wright's going to get a drop for a loss, and I think I cut out these plays just a little fast, so the plays almost start immediately. I don't know if that was a good thing or a bad thing. But our second play of the day, we get sacked. Third play of the day, we give a draw to Leon Washington, because I do like to play realistically. I like doing draws on third and long. I don't throw Hail Marys on third and long, unless I'm losing by a lot, and it's close to the end of the game. So, in the very beginning of the game, no one's really getting anything going on their drives. The Pittsburgh Steelers finally get a first down there. Isaac Redman, I don't know, I say it two different ways, judge me. He gets a couple yards there, gets first down, and there's the first big completion of the game. Ben Roethlisberger to Mike Wallace, who still is not on the team currently as of Saturday, the day before Easter. We get a sack there, and we're going to get another sack here, but their center Starks, I believe that's their center Starks, comes up with the fumble recovery. They're forced to punt, and Marshawn Lynch doing a little mini beast mode, getting a stiff arm, shedding some tackles there. Third and six, we're going to hit Braylon Edwards for, I believe, our first down of the game. He's got about 18 yards receiving on the day. And we couldn't really get much going today in the running game so far. Marshawn Lynch is going to cough up the ball there. And the Steelers are going to come away with a fumble recovery. And on their third and five, they're going for Mike Wallace. And he's going to get dropped before he can get to the first down line. So they're going to settle for a field goal. And as you can tell by that little circle, they missed. They missed their first field goal of the game. So we are with some pretty decent field goal, or pretty decent field position, I should say. Like I said, Marshawn Lynch really wasn't getting anything going. I feel like I edited these clips really fast, like they start almost immediately when I transition to the next clip. But we get a first down, we hit Mike Williams there for an 8-yard pass, and Marshawn Lynch is going to pick up the first down, but it's going to get called back for holding, and don't worry guys, it wasn't John Moffitt. I don't believe John Moffitt had a penalty this game. Pretty good game by John Moffitt. He should have been MVP just because he didn't have a holding call. But you're going to see Sidney Rice got injured there, and that was a fail punt. But Sidney Rice would come back to the game. What was I saying? I don't know. Yeah, okay. So this is already a fail on this 18-minute commentary. Isaac Redman, he gets an 8-yard game. I keep saying it two different ways, and then we stop them for a loss. So far throughout one quarter, no one has anything going. The Steelers had a missed field goal, And as you can see, Leon Washington only had 4 yards rushing on 2 attempts. Jericho Cotri is going to get the reception there. Haven't really seen much of Jericho Cotri in these past few years since he's been off the Steelers. And look at Brandon Browner with his awareness getting that interception. That wasn't even a user pick. So hate me all you want. Haters gonna hate. Marshawn Lynch picking up a good 9 yards there. 5 rushes for 17 yards. Not a very good average. And tried scrambling there with Tavarius Jackson. Couldn't get it. We got dropped for a sack. 3rd and 2. Tavarius Jackson just looking for anyone. And we get dropped for another sack. So we're going to have to settle for the field goal, I should say. And this one is good, giving us the 3-0 lead with about 7 minutes left in the half. And Isaac Redman's going to get another carry there. The Steelers seem to want to run the ball a lot this game. Redman gets a good block there, but he's going to get taken down by KJ Wright. If that was Mendenhall, who knows, that could have been a touchdown, because he is way faster than Redman. And Roethlisberger, like I said, he, for some reason, wanted to scramble on almost every single play this game. Like, there you go. 2 plays in a row, he's just going to scramble. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's his tendencies or whatnot or whatever. But Melody Moore is going to get a 5-yard gain there. Like I said, they wanted to run the ball a lot this game. And it was working pretty well for them. Melody Moore gets another good rush there, about 10 yards. Then they're going to play action there to Mike Wallace. And Brandon Browner is going to come up with another pick. Yes, I user controlled that one. And for the next season, I'm going to try to user control a little bit less, because it is kind of cheap. I don't know. I have mixed feelings on it, but it's just like an instinct of mine. Like, I can't help but to user control a guy and try to pick it off. I don't know. It's just like programmed in my brain to do that. But Braylon Edwards is going to pick up a first down with about 3 minutes left in the second quarter. So we're looking to get down the field, and I don't know what that was. If you saw that was like a little glitch. It glitched out a little bit. 2nd and 10, Tavarius Jackson, horrible pass to Sidney Rice. I can't wait till next season when we actually have a somewhat decent quarterback. You'll see who I picked up. Sidney Rice going to fumble it there, but we get the fumble recovery with Mike Williams. Braylon Edwards on the reverse, and he's going to fumble this one. So I believe Braylon Edwards had 2 fumbles back-to-back. Not too good. We have 3 fumbles so far in this game, 1 from Marshawn Lynch and 2 from Braylon Edwards, and we recovered only 1 of them. So, the Steelers are looking to put up some points. Ben Roethlisberger once again wants to scramble. Don't know why. 3rd and 7, Ben Roethlisberger dropping back, and he's going to scramble again. I don't know. Like, I think I said this last time when we played the Steelers and beat them in the regular season, like week 2. I think he's getting himself confused with Michael Vick, that number 7 on his jersey. And look at this. On 3rd down, they're going to get called for roughing the passer. So, we're going to get a 1st down out of that. A little break for us. Marshawn Lynch is going to get the little dinky pass there. We're going to get an incomplete pass, resulting to 3rd down. And Sidney Rice, look at this catch. He's going to break off a tackle, and he's going to make his way into the end zone, giving us the 1st touchdown of the game, giving us a 10-0 lead going into the half. But with 9 seconds left after a squib kick, the Steelers have pretty good field position. So they're going to pick up some yards, and now they're going to attempt the very long, the 59-yard field goal, and they're going to miss just by a little bit. Maybe if it was like a 57, they would have made it, but they didn't. And once again, like I said, we couldn't really get the running game going. Marshawn Lynch was not having a good game. He was not having a beast mode this game. And I just kept trying to force the running game. And look at this screen pass to Leon Washington. He is one of the fastest men on the field right now. He's going to outrun everyone, and he's going to get a touchdown here. And watch this at the very end of the touchdown at the top left. Yes, he gets injured. Broken ribs. He looks fine to me, but I guess the medical staff saw something different. It seems like he was walking just fine, but he's going to miss the remainder of the game. And Ben Roethlisberger once again scrambling. I don't know what his problem was. And that could have been a deadly play if Redman could have made it to the corner. But we get the stop in the backfield. Maybe that was the backfield. I don't remember. And I tried user picking that on Mwolde Moore. But it's all right because we stop him before the 1st down line. So we get the ball back. And Sidney Rice is going to get a nice 6-yard catch there. He has 76 yards on the game. And Marshawn Lynch, once again, not having a very good game. I think he was only averaging like 2 yards per carry up to this point. And we could not get the 1st down there. And Sidney Rice going to get injured again. But he will return to the game. The injury thing never even popped up. Look at this punt by John Ryan, getting it down to the 1-yard line. So we were just pressuring them. I guess you call that a nano blitz. Just went right through the offensive line and dropped down Roethlisberger. Didn't count as a sack, though, because he picked up some yards. But the Steelers couldn't get anything going because of that horrible field position. So now with the punt, we have pretty good field position. Marshawn Lynch is going to hold on to the ball there from the Steelers' attempted strip. Marshawn Lynch going to get another decent gain there. He's only got 24 yards rushing on 12 attempts. Third and one, we're trying to get a first down there, but we're going to be stopped short. So on fourth and inches, we're going to have to settle for another field goal. And this one is good, giving us the 20-0 lead. So far into the third, it's looking ugly. The Steelers really haven't had much going, and Brown is going to get the reception there, giving them a first down. He has 20 yards on 2 receptions on the day, and Redmond's going to get stopped short on first down. I don't know why I said stopped short, but Ben Roethlisberger is going to complete to Brown again. He's going to pick up another about 10, 11 yards to bring them another first down, and hey, is that Michael Vick? Wait, no, that's Ben Roethlisberger, so I don't quite understand why he's scrambling so much this game. I swear he had more attempts than the running back this game. Look at this. Another running attempt by Ben Roethlisberger. I guess he didn't see anyone, so he tried scrambling again. That one I can understand, but all the other ones, I don't understand why he scrambles so much. Third and 5, Ben Roethlisberger hitting Mike Wallace for a first down. So they're getting close to putting up their first points of the game. And look at this, another like nano blitz by Leroy Hill, getting a sack there. Second and 12, they're going to give it to Isaac Redmond. And he's going to get stopped for only a 3-yard gain. Third and 9, Ben Roethlisberger is going to get dropped for a sack. And look at this fourth down call. Very questionable. Fourth and 17, a draw play to Redmond. Why? If you're looking to pick up 17 yards, why a draw play on fourth down? I can understand maybe on third down, but fourth? And look, Marshawn Lynch finally breaks out a good run, but we're going to get called for clipping. I believe that was on Zach Miller. I didn't show it. Like I said, it wasn't John Moffitt. John Moffitt actually had a good game. He hasn't had a holding in a while. I haven't seen a holding by John Moffitt in quite a bit. And speaking of John Moffitt, I found his Twitter account, which is pretty sweet. He tweeted me back. I thought it was pretty cool. But yeah, fanboy aside, we're going to get stopped on third down with the pass of the fullback. And here we go, another good punt by John Ryan. I believe this is at the 2-yard line, so I was like, hey, let's blitz them. And almost got a safety there. So they're just trying to get better field position. And I don't really understand how this was called a safety, but it was. I guess he never got the ball out of the end zone, but I swore it looked like it did. So we get the ball back with 2 points on the board. Marshawn Lynch breaking off a tackle. That was probably his best run of the game. 16 rushes for 32 yards. Once again, only 2 yards per carry. And Lynch is going to fumble it there, and Robert Gallery is going to pick it up. So Justin Forsett on 2nd and 15 is going to pick up about 7 yards there. Actually, exactly 7 yards there. And we're going to run it again on third down because we already had the lead. We're up 22 points. So there was no need to pass it. Yes, I play realistically. Yes, I could have probably scored a touchdown on that drive if I wanted to, but I didn't because I like to play realistically, something a lot of people don't like to do. So the Pittsburgh Steelers really need to score now, and look at this sack by Atari Bigby, the former Packer. Kind of looked like a horse collar. Is that what it's called? Horse collar? Whatever. But Ben Roethlisberger throws a pick directly to Fabian Washington. And that's pretty much going to seal the game for us. There's only 5:40 left in the game. This is the part where we just try to run down the clock, trying to get another touchdown. Marshawn Lynch could not get anything going. Third down, we're going to call a draw play and get stopped for a loss. So we're going to settle for a field goal on fourth and goal, bringing this up 25-0. And with only 3:23 left in the game, it's not looking like the Steelers are going to do it. Ben Roethlisberger is going to try anyways, hitting Jericho Cotchery. And yes, I try to strip the ball way too much. Maybe I'll stop trying as hard next season. And we're going to stop the Steelers short. So with only 2 minutes left in the game, yeah, we're just going to run down the clock. We just need to pick up a first down first. Another good run by Marshawn Lynch. I don't know how he wasn't tackled earlier, because there was like 3 guys hovering around him the entire time. And the Steelers weren't calling timeouts, but I still didn't want to do a QB kneel just in case they were just like mind-effing me. I don't know. But eventually we will kneel the ball down, and the Seattle Seahawks will get revenge for the last Super Bowl where the Steelers beat them. We're going to come away with a 25-0 win. And here we go. Here's the celebration. I know you guys have probably seen it a bunch of times, and I should probably stop talking around the part where, you know, currently where they're talking about the Seattle Seahawks finished off last season 7-9 and all that good stuff. But honestly, last time I did one of these, I got a copyright strike, so I really don't want to risk it again. And they need to fix the presentation for Madden 13, because the confetti looks really crappy and it doesn't stick to the ground, which is kind of annoying. And the whole thing, the whole Super Bowl thing, needs to be fixed. They need to have, like, all the security people come onto the field and just have 7 billion people on the field. But you're going to see that, I believe, Chris Clemens, I don't know if it showed it yet, is going to win the MVP trophy. I don't know why Tavares Jackson's holding it there. Actually, probably because he's the quarterback. So, nice little high five to Pete Carroll. So, Pete Carroll's going to get his first Super Bowl win and only his second season as the head coach as the Seattle Seahawks. Head coach for the Seattle Seahawks, not as the Seattle Seahawks. So, yeah, this is just a little Super Bowl ending thing. Like I said, you guys have probably seen it a bunch of times. Didn't want to skip it, though, because it's, come on, it's the Super Bowl celebration. There's Tavares Jackson. I hope that's Tavares Jackson. Looks like him because he's got that mustache. I don't know if Pryor has the mustache. Because I accidentally started Pryor in the game because I had Tavares Jackson out of the lineup from the previous games because he was injured. So I had Terrell Pryor in for the very first play of the game. And I don't know why there's only red and blue ties. It's like the Jaguars ties. And if you saw the guy on the left, he looks exactly like AJ Hawk. That play, yeah, right there, that's AJ, tell me that's not AJ Hawk. That's like the only player model for someone with long hair. They all look like AJ Hawk, which I think is pretty funny, but he got a haircut now, so you can't say it's AJ Hawk anymore. So we pretty much dominated the Steelers and everything, only 88 rushing yards and 99 passing yards by the Steelers. They beat us out in rushing, but we beat them out in passing. Tavares Jackson actually had a really good game, 13 of 22, 223 yards. Ben Roethlisberger, 12 of 19, 135 yards. Only we had 2 touchdowns and no interceptions. He had no touchdowns and 3 interceptions. Marshawn Lynch, only 1.6 yards per carry. Isaiah Redman, only 2.8. Ben Roethlisberger had 7 rushes for 25 yards. Like, come on. Mwelde Moore had a pretty good game, 14 yards on 3 rushes. And here are the receiving stats. Sidney Rice leads the crew with 6 receptions for 93 yards, 1 touchdown. And the only person with a touchdown was Leon Washington with that 80-yard screen pass. And I'm going to show you the defensive stuff. Total tackles, I believe, yeah, Smith led the way. A bunch of people, it's 8 and 7. We're going to show tackles for losses. No, yes, no, yes, maybe, no. We're going to show sacks. So, Chris Clemens had 3 sacks on the day. I know I just said shacks. Brandon Browner had 2 interceptions. And I forgot to mention, John Ryan was really the MVP for the second half for all of those awesome punts. But I believe that's going to wrap up this video. I think I'm done showing the stats. Next video is going to be the offseason, which is a very long video and I blabber on a lot. But that'll be up soon. But I hope you guys enjoyed this very long video. Thought it was pretty special. Yes, I'm talking past everything. But I thought this should be a good video to make a long video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And as always, thank you for watching. Seattle Seahawks win the Super Bowl. Not very realistic. And tune in next time.